And that one skies to second. It's going to fall for a base hit. Gabriel on his horse. He's running home. The throw. In time, and the Peewees go up by a 3 to score 3-1. Diaboost reaches, and now the ball gets thrown to the outfield. No one's covering third. Diaboost round second. Stuck in between.
Welcome you on this blustery, humid afternoon in Kahnawake to the hospital ball field. It's our Sunnyside Diner game of the week, brought to you by, of course, Sunnyside Diner, with dining options now available and breakfast served until 2 every day. Give them a call today, 450-635-7983. And this matchup is between the 1-0 DDO Dodgers and the Kahnawake Warhawks, who have been rained out twice, hoping to get this season started off on the right foot. They did that last year with the victory over, well, it was a Kahnawake versus Kahnawake affair. Our starting pitcher, Rosanagete Lahash, wearing number 45, and he'll face a lineup which starts off with a left-handed batter fouling this one back, and that is James Weishart. So Weishart, Marco Piccioni, and Miles Spinner, the three Dodgers due up here in the top of this first inning. And here's the 0-1 from Lahash. That ball, it's a ball off the plate, 1-1 the count. Dodgers started their season off in impressive fashion, a 14-1 win over St. Laurent, the black team, the Crush Noir. We've seen the Warhawks. They're going to have a real busy week coming up here. They got games Thursday, Friday, and Sunday. A real busy week for Kahnawake as the 2-1 comes in upstairs, and it's now 3-1 the count. We take a look at the Warhawks defensively. Casey Diaboost behind the plate. Over at first base, they have Joran Norton, and there's ball four and a leadoff walk for James Weishart here in the top of the first inning. Over at second, Cade Stacey, Ethan Brascoop at short, Lily Barnes over at third, and meanwhile in the outfield, we have Jaden Norton playing right, Marcus Rice in center, and Cage McCumber down in left. So it's a 1-0 count. Remember, at the PWB level, no stealing. There is stealing at Pee-wee A, and obviously Bantam B too. And this pitch goes behind.
Up.
And it's a, well, I'm corrected right away, because that's a steal. As Weishart goes down to second. So it's a 2-0 count, and Weishart now in scoring position for DDO. The 2-0, and he swing, there's a swing and a miss. 2-1 the count. Weishart stays on second. Diaboost behind the bag at the catcher position. Here's the 2-1 offering. That's in there, called strike two, and it evens the count at 2-2. It's one of those pitches where if it was strike three, it'd be a little too close to call. You definitely expect Piccioni to pull the trigger next time. That's inside, and it fulls, makes the count full at 3-2. Miles Spinner on deck for DDO. First game of the year for the Warhawks. The full count pitch. That's a little high, and it's ball four. Ronnie Stacy, too, is going to have quite the busy week with pitching. Four games in 6 days. They play today, they play Thursday, they play Friday, they play Sunday. Oh, my. That'll be a 3-4 stretch as well. A spinner, the three hitter steps in. It's ball one outside. 1-0 count. Lahash winds, sets, and delivers. That's in there, and it's an even count now. One ball, one strike. Spinner lays off, and it's now 2-1. Elliot Lennon on deck for DDO. The pitch. And he swings and misses at that. And now they're going to go. The throw to third. Barnes with the catch and not able to handle it. Wiseman's in. Good throw by Diabouz, but a little off. Just a tiny, just a hair off. Good throw, however, down that third base line, and Wiseman now 90 feet away from home. Pacciuni, by the way, stayed at first. And that loads the count here for Lahash, 3-2. That's ball four and three straight walks to start the game for Rosanagete Lahash. Three straight full counts too, so he's right there. He's knocking on the door. Speaking of knocking on the door, that's what DDO is doing right now as Elliot Lennon steps in and hits this one well. Knocked down by Brascoop, and he's not able to throw anyone out. Good play by Ethan. That force probably at least kept one DDO runner out, but one Dodger scores, and it's 1-0 for the visitors here in the top of the first. Well hit ball, and Maximus Leokopoulos will step in, the number five hitter. Fouls this one back, it's 0-1. No balls and a strike to Leokopoulos, the number five hitter. Dodgers have the bases loaded and nobody out here in the top of the first, leading 1-0. And he lays off of this pitch, so it's 1-1. And not only do we have to think about this, but Ronnie Stacy's going to have to juggle pitchers for four games over the next week. The 1-1. Upstairs, and that'll make it a 2-1 count. Don't forget, a walk here would force in a DDO run. The 2-1. Hit well the second, caught by Brascoop. And the liner will force out number one. Good play by the shortstop, Brascoop, who makes that catch. And it's been a busy inning for him at short. One down, and Parker Shoren will step in. Shoren, the pitcher, starting tonight for DDO. The pitch off the bag, 1-0. Pacciuni at third, Spinner at second, Lennon at first, and one DDO runner has already scored. It's 1-0 for the Dodgers. When Shoren hanging off of that one. Looked like he had a little thought to take a swing at it, but held off nonetheless. Right decision. The 2-0 is outside, and now it's 3-0. Nothing, guys, nothing. That is ball four, and that'll force in a second DDO run. It's not the prettiest baseball, but four walks for DDO has resulted in a 2-0 lead, and this is exactly the kind of start you want. If you're the visitors, don't even let the home team get into it. One to Brandon Rosen stepping in for Dollard. Bases loaded, 2-0 lead for the Dodgers. And that's in there, and it evens the count at 1-1. Remember, it's a maximum 5, I believe. The pitch. That's outside for ball two, and it's now a 2-1 count. Here's the pitch. That misses away, and it's now 3-1. And if Rosen just keeps laying off here and the ball doesn't find the strike zone, DDO will have themselves a 3-0 lead. The throw. That's in there, and now we've got a full count, 3-2. The full count offering. Fouled back, and we're going to have a 7th pitch of this at-bat coming up. That might have been a pitch that Rosen would have laid off if it was not a 2-strike count. Protect that plate, though. That's what his third base coach was telling him. The 3-2. Strike three. And that is a huge strikeout for Rosen Aguete Lahash. And Gabriel Azuelos will step in. 2-0 lead for DDO. And that's outside, off the plate, and it's 1-0. Forget, there's two outs here, so the Dodgers are running on anything that gets hit, pretty much. And that's upstairs. And now it's 2-0. That's not going to hit the strike zone, and now Lahash in a 3-0 hole. Jeremy Swisha is on deck for DDO. And that's going to be ball four. And it's 3-0 Dodgers with Suiza stepping in. Suiza and then Nathan Elbaz do up here. That's ball one. And Ronnie Stacy is going to come to the mound. To visit with his pitcher, Rosen Aguete Lahash. Well, this is our second regular season broadcast here on Baby Blue Memories of the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week. The other one, of course, the Midget Warhawks, or the U-18 Warhawks. Unofficially a 1-0 win over Soulanges, but they were up 8-7 in the bottom of the fifth when the game was called due to forfeiture by the Cougars for illegal equipment. Yours truly will be invited to do a special podcast on your USA tomorrow. A big thank you going out to Greg Horn for the invitation. And we've got plenty of baseball to talk about. The Baltimore Hawks gotten off to a 2-0 start as well, following a big win over Soulanges this past Saturday, as both the Bantam and Midget Warhawks swept that doubleheader with Soulanges on Saturday. And the Girl Hawks, of course, the younger Girl Hawks, getting off to a 2-0 start as well, winning two games in DDO. Or Pierrefonds, sorry, in Pierrefonds it was. And it's 2-0 right now on Suisa. Lahash just has to get this one over the plate. His defense behind him has been solid. And that's a swing and a miss. And it'll make it a 2-1 count. Warhawks in the red, the Dodgers in the blue. DDO up 3-0, and it's a 2-1 count to Suisa at the deck, at bat. The pitch. Inside. That's a hit by pitch, sorry. So Suisa gets plunked. And the Dodgers have now scored 4 on one base hit. Good patience, good plate discipline by DDO. And this will be the final batter of the inning, no matter what happens. Nathan Albaz stepping in. So either DDO will score 5 and max out their inning, or they will score 4 and the Warhawks will prevent or will avoid being maxed out here in the top of the first. 1-0 the count on Albaz. The pitch. And that's a good pitch from Rosanegete Lahash. It's now 1-1. The 1-1. One hops the bag, and it's going to be 2-1 now, the count. That's upstairs, and it's now 3-1. The pitch. And that is ball 4, and that is the max. So the Dodgers score 5 to start this one off. And the Warhawks will be coming up to bat with a little bit of work to do as DDO takes a 5-0 lead into the bottom of the first. You're watching Baby Blue Memories. And we welcome you back to the hospital ball field, the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week. Now available for dining. Give us a call, 450-635-7983. Don't forget, we have breakfast served right up until 2 o'clock. As we present to you, Parker Zorin, number 24, facing the lineup, which is headed by Lily Barnes, leading off. She's ahead in the count 2-0. Got a left-handed catcher back there, which is a rarity to see. And right now, Barnes is quickly in a 3-0 lead. But we had Casey Diabuse leading us off. And that is ball 4 in a leadoff walk. Looks like we had a flip-flop of players. So Barnes is aboard and Brascoop will step in. And he hits this one right back to the pitcher. Caught! They have a chance to pick her off at first. And they do for the double play. And that's 2 quick outs. Diabuse was picked off. So Casey Diabuse drew the walk. And now it's up to number 26 on this team, real Lily Barnes. So the lineup was right. And it's a 1-0 start for Barnes after Diabous walked and Braskoop lined it to a double play. And this innings only lasted 2 minutes after a 17-minute top of the first. So for the Warhawks, they're going to really want to just milk their time here and get their pitching staff a little bit of a break. As a strike is called at the knees, making it a 2-1 count. Ball inside, and now it's 3-1. Cade Stacy on deck for Kahnawake. Shoren sets and deals. And Barnes not able to make contact with that, and that'll make it a full count, 3-2. The pitch. And that's some high cheese, which Barnes lays off and draws the walk. And now Cade Stacy will step in. Cage McCumber on deck. Warhawks trying to get some two-run magic going here in the bottom of the first. And that pitch is a little behind Cade for ball one. The pitch. Cade swings and is not able to make contact. It's an even count now, 1-1. Smoked well to second, knocked down, and they will tag her out. Well hit ball, but just in the wrong place. And that is gonna do it for the Warhawks in the bottom of the first. DDO in front by 5. We're coming back with the top of the second. Top of the lineup due up for the Dodgers. You're watching Baby Blue Memories. We welcome you back to the Arena Ball Field for the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week, the DDO Dodgers and Kahnawake Warhawks. DDO on top by a score of 5-0. They had one base hit in that first inning and still scored 5. That shows you the importance of plate discipline, and that is something which DDO executed to perfection last week in their win against St. Laurent. Warhawks, a real busy schedule. As we mentioned, on the road Thursday, back here Friday, and then on the road again next Sunday. So this is a 4-game-in-6-day stretch for the Warhawks as a result of those 2 rained-out games last week. New pitcher on the mound for Kahnawake, Marcus Rice, number 17. Rosinaguete Lahash pitched the first, and he is now playing in, I believe, center field. And the top of the lineup due up here for DDO, starting with Weishart, who walked and scored back in the first inning. Marcus Rice sets, winds, and delivers. That is upstairs and away for ball one. Weishart, Piccioni, and Spinner up for DDO in the top of the second inning. Here's the pitch. And that's fouled right back and making it a 1-1 count now. That last inning lasted just 3 minutes after DDO, their top of the inning was 17. So for the Warhawks, we want to try and get something quick out of this and go to work on offense. But the DDO players are laying off of the high heat from Marcus Rice. He's going to have to lower his target just a little bit so he can find that strike zone. That's in there, and it's a called second strike. And now anything close really will put pressure on Weishart to swing that bat. You do not want to go down on strikes, but especially not looking. It's in the dirt. And that makes it a full count, 3-2. DDO up 5-0 here in the top of the second inning. Here's the pitch. Ooh. Some chin music for Weishart, and he draws a walk for the second time today. And now Pacioni will step in. The pitch. Hit well the third. Barnes knocks it down. What a play at third. And they get her at second. Good play at third by Lily Barnes to make that play, and there's one down. It's just the top of the second. Well, that's got to be a good feeling, really reassuring feeling for the Warhawks pitching staff, because now they know that their defense is really back there for them. And that's strike one to Miles Spinner, who walked and scored back in the top of the first. And that's strike two. And Marcus Rice hoping to keep the pedal to the metal for the Warhawks here in the second inning. That's outside, and it's now 1-2. Elliot Lennon due up for DDO after this. He's got the only hit of the game for DDO, but five-run lead, you're not going to argue the results. It's efficient, that is for sure. Ooh. Well, Spinner had to get out of the way of that, and it's an even count now, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Pacioni at first. Hit on the ground, but foul. And that'll keep this at-bat alive, and pitch number 6 of the at-bat is coming up right now. It's the one thing that DDO was really deflating for the Warhawks pitching in the top of the first inning was the fact that it felt like every walk went to a full count. And this one skied to short. And it gets over! And the runner safe at second. And there's a big time draft here behind that ball. That took a nasty hit to the outfield. Elliot Lennon due up. Pitch from to Lennon here. That's ball one. Here's the 1-0 from Marcus Rice. Hit well, caught! The throw to second, not in time! A hot shot right to short, and Russ Gabriel makes the play for out number two. And now, Maximus Leokopoulos will step in for DDO. A hot shot to short. Gabriel makes the play. And this one skied into shallow center. That will fall. It's a base hit. Runner's going home. Throw home. Oh, they got him! What a throw! What a throw at second by Cade Stacey, and the Warhawks get out of that inning without surrendering a run. And let's see if the offense can get on track. It's DDO by 5, headed to the bottom of the second inning. You're watching Baby Blue Memories. We welcome you back to the hospital ball field, bottom of the second inning. The DDO Dodgers in front of the Kahnawake Warhawks by a score of 5-0. Parker Shoren in there to pitch his second inning. And he will face the 5-6-7 hitters. So Cage McCumber leading off. And McCumber, Jada Norton, and then Lahash. As ball one goes off the plate and nearly into the kitchen of McCumber. And the sky is starting to gray a little bit here. That's strike one. But like the Temptations said, we hope that we're providing that sunshine on a cloudy day. Ball two. Certainly not cold outside. Nice little breeze though being provided here. 5-0 lead for the Dodgers and a 2-1 count. Make it 2-2 now on Cage McCumber. Being Shoran. And now it's a full count, 3-2. Jaden Norton, Rosanagete Lahash coming up after this. The pitch. That's strike three in the first out here in the bottom of the second inning. And Jaden Norton will step in. One in the dirt and away. DDO 5, Kahnawake, no score. This officially U-13. I'm still going to call it Pee-wee more often than not, though. And that's some chin music. Norton has to duck out of the way for ball two. The 2-0. Off the plate, and now quickly it's a 3-0 count. One down here in the bottom of the second. DDO up by 5. And Norton swings a little behind that one. It's now 3-1. It's a ball. That's ball four. So Norton's aboard here in the bottom of the second inning. And in steps Rosanagete Lahash. Runner on first, one down in the bottom of the second inning. Warhawks down by a score of 5-0 to DDO. Lahash at its 0-1. The pitch. Oh! Well, Lahash just got hit in the head by a pitch, and he's gonna have to be subbed out. He seems to be okay, and he's going to have to be subbed out till the next inning after getting hit in the head by a pitch. So Barnes will step in and pinch run, and hoping to hear some good news from Rosanagete Lahash. Two runners on now with one out for the Warhawks. And that's hit well to second. And they missed her. And the bases are loaded. They missed her. Jackson Norton with the base hit to load the bases. In that situation, you just throw it down to third. If you can't get the double play, you got a 5-0 lead. Just get that lead runner out, and now we're gonna have a discussion between Shoran and the catcher. Bases loaded here, one down for the Warhawks, and a golden opportunity for Rosanagete Gabriel. So that's the DDO coach telling his players any bag is really the target here. That's strike one on Gabriel, 0-1 the count. 5-0 lead for the Dodgers here in the bottom of the second inning. And that's going to one hop the bag to even the count at one ball, one strike. That's outside and away, and now it's two balls and a strike. And Gabriel lays off of it, and now it's 3-1. And the Warhawks knocking on the board, knocking on the door to get on the board here. Gabriel hits this one well through the gap, and it finds its way through. One run scores. Barnes on her horse, she will score. Jackson Norton coming around third, he will score. Gabriel's going for it. Rasanahawe Gabriel, grand salami. Well, Pee Wee Warhawks, welcome to the game. A grand slam for Rasanahawe Gabriel, and it's 5-4. And now Joran Norton will step in. Rasanahawe Gabriel with a grand salami inside the park home run to make it a 5-4 game. Well, did that ever get this crowd here at the hospital ball field rocking? Marcus Rice coming up the bat afterwards. And then we'll be back to the top of the lineup with Casey Diabus afterwards. 5-4 lead, DDO one down here. And that smacked the second. Knocked down, the throw across the diamond will not be in time, and it is a single for Joran Norton. And the pitch actually got away. The pitch got away from Parker, and meanwhile, a hustling Joran Norton gets down to second. So the tying run in scoring position here for the Warhawks with one out. One down in this bottom of the second inning. The Warhawks have put four up, looking to max out and tie this one up as the ball misses. And you know Norton is going to be keeping an eye on the catcher, who's in a actually advantageous position when throwing down to first, but throwing down to third might be a little difficult. That's in there. Good pitch by Shoren. Have scored four, but it's still the Dodgers in front right now, 5-4. And we've got a hit batsman. Was that a that's a hit batter, which should be a dead ball, right? That's runners on first and second now as Marcus Rice goes over to first. So Casey Diabus now in. She drew a walk back in the first inning. 5-4 lead for DDO. And fouled back by Diabus, 0-1 the count. 5-4 lead for the Dodgers. DDO scored five in the very first inning, but the Warhawks have put up four here in this second. Led by Rasanahawe Gabriel with a inside the park grand slam to make this a one run game. And now the runners are going. Joran Norton on his horse. And he's in at third. And now a shot to the outfield would pretty much, well, not guarantee, but be possibly good enough to get a sacrifice fly. One hops the bag, and Norton you see at third, waiting for his chance. 5-4 DDO. Marcus, Here's the pitch. Off the plate. Honestly, a walk here with the bases loaded and one out might be a good thing for DDO because it forces a play at home. And that is now a full count. 3-2 on Diet Boost. But if you get the strikeout, you're not going to argue either. 5-4 lead DDO here in the bottom of the second. That's in there, and that is a huge strikeout for Parker Shore, and it's out number two. And Ethan Brascoop will step in. Young Parker Shoren, that is music to your ears. And not the Brandon Bordeaux singing kind of music, if you want to even call it that. Two outs. Runners on second and third, but only Joran Norton can score as Brascoop steps in. That's in there. It catches the inside corner, 0-1. Barnes can technically hit this inning. She's on deck. And that would be if there's a walk or a hit by pitch, or if the runners don't run, but with two outs, I don't think that's something you don't want to do. You want to do. Brascoop hits this one to first. It bounces over the first baseman, and we have a five spot. And the Kahnawake Warhawks have tied this game after being down five. We're heading back to the top of the third. DDO 5, Kahnawake 5. And she's a ball game now here on the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week. Dodgers coming up the bat, top of the third. You're watching Baby Blue Memories. We welcome you back to the Kahnawake Hospital Ballfield, Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week. Forget breakfast available till 2, and now the dining is open. Call us 450-635-7983, where it's Sunnyside Diner, where it's always sunny in this ball one. On Parker Shoren, who pitched a solid first inning, and in that second inning had a big strikeout. But a well-hit ball that jumped over his first baseman resulted in that five spot. There's a slow roller. Fair ball, they say. The throw down the line. It's not in time, and Shoren gets to first. And now with the game tied at five, don't forget, the Dodgers will be allowed to steal. You gotta be aware of that. As Brandon Rosen is now in the batter's box. That's strike one. Good pitch from Marcus Rice. One of the strong arms on this pitching staff for Ronnie Stacey, who is going to have to find a balance because, as we know, 4 games in 6 days, including tonight, for this U-13 Warhawks team. Upstairs, and that makes it a 2-1 count. Runner on first base. Top of the third inning. We're all squared here at five. Off the plate. And now it's 3-1. And we got some strong wind here. That's in there at the knees. Runner thinking about going, but he backs up. We'll see what happens here. A 3-2 count coming up from Marcus Rice against Brandon Rosen. That's in there, right down Broadway, they say, for out number one. And now Gabriel as Wellows will step in. He drew a walk back in the first inning, which forced in a run, so he does have an RBI today. And they call this one in there for strike one. One down, runner on first, 5-5 score here in the top of the second inning. Or top of the third, sorry. And there's strike two. Marcus Rice bringing the heat here in this relief appearance. Rosinaguete Lahash got the start. And Marcus came in for relief last inning. That misses. Runner's going!
Stay there!
And it is a stolen base for Parker Shoren. So he gets 90 feet away and is now in scoring position with one down.
Not trying to watch going, Parker.
The pitch. Off the plate, 2-2. Jordan Norton at third. Gabriel at third. Or sorry, Gabriel's at short. Real busy mat today, and it's a full count. Diaboost at second. Jackson Norton at first for this Warhawks team. Defensively, bases, runner on second, one down, full count. Coming up, the pitch. Oh, that hit him, I believe. They hit the bat. That's a foul ball.
They hit the bat.
They hit the back of the bat. They never prepare you for when the pitch is behind you to get your bat out of the way. They teach you to get out of the way. So now we've got a full count again. And that is ball four, and it is a walk. A seven pitch at bat resulting in a walk, and a good job by Gabriel Azuelos. And Jeremy Suiza steps in. He was hit by a pitch back in the first inning. It bounces. They will get the force out at second. And there's two out with runners on the corners. So Shoren gets the third. Azuelos, however, was tagged out, running from second to first. So there's runners on the corners, two outs in a 5-5 ball game here at the top of the third inning. The pitch. That's in there. Good pitch from Marcus Rice. Forget the force is at either second or first. Shoren does not need to run. He will, though, with two outs. I think the coach will tell him you do need to run. Here's the 0-1. Hit off the ground. Back to Gabriel, who will step on second, and the Warhawks get out of this inning without surrendering a run. So we're heading into the bottom of the third. Our score, Kahnawake Warhawks 5, DDO Dodgers 5. And the top of the lineup, or sorry, the 3-4-5 hitters due up, Barnes, Stacy, Cage, McCumber. You're watching Baby Blue Memories. We welcome you back to the Kahnawake Hospital Ball Fields. Bottom of the third inning. This, of course, the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week. And it's been a barn burner up to this point. The DDO Dodgers raced out to a 5-0 lead, and the Kahnawake Warhawks have stormed back to tie it up, and now with an opportunity to take the lead as we head to the bottom of the third inning. James Weishart, number 14, into pitch, and he will face a lineup which will consist of Lily Barnes, Cade Stacey, Cage McCumber, 3-4-5, here in the bottom of the third inning. And the first pitch, Barnes swings and fouls this one off, making it 0-1 the count. Again, Russell Nahoe Gabriel with a huge grand slam inside the park home run back in the bottom of the second to level this thing up, or at least help to level this thing up, as the ball misses away. 1-1 the count. Looking at the Dodgers defensively on the right side of the field, we have Azuelos over at third. Maximus Leokopoulos over at short, and this one's upstairs. Jeremy Suisa in right. That's the right side of the defensive lineup for the Dodgers. And that pitch is in there, and it's now 1-2. Here's the 1-2 pitch. And that will not hit the plate. And actually, that makes it a full count, 3-2. Wiseman, the pitcher. Elliot Lennon is at first. And Barnes lays off the high heat. And she will be permitted to take her base, I believe. Yes, she will. It's a leadoff walk for Barnes, and Cade Stacey will step in. He's 0-1, grounded out back in his last at-bat, which was the first inning, which almost seems like a total different game ago. And Stacey, swinging for the fences, gets air, and it's 0-1. And that's upstairs, 1-1 the count. Upstairs, and now 2-1 the count. And this Warhawks team will have a very busy week. We have a very, very busy week too. We may be seeing U-18 action on Thursday in St. Lazare as Stacey fouls this one back. This is, of course, the Sunnyside Diner game of the week. 450-635-7983, Sunnyside Diner, where it's always sunny in this. Back to the action. The pitch. Stacey was really tempted to swing at that one, but he held back. 2-2 the count. Barnes at first, and on deck is McCumber, number 39. And that misses. And now the runners are on first and second, so runners in scoring position. Cage McCumber will step in. So we got McCumber, a righty, in here, stepping in. Here's the pitch. That finds the inside corner, 0-1 the count. Runners on first and second, no outs. And it looks like Marcus Rice will come back and pitch a third inning. This one way upstairs. Barnsby tilled the hole back. Good play behind the backstop by the catcher. 5-5, and now the Sun trying to overpower the Gray, almost like these two teams trying to overpower one another. As McCumber has to get out of the way. 2-1 the count. And McCumber lays off. That's in there. 2-2 the count. This would be a huge strikeout for Weishart if he's able to do it. He gets it, and a huge strikeout for James Weishart here in the bottom of the third. And now Jada Norton will step into the batter's box. She walked and scored and hits this one off her foot. Rolling. It won't go. The throw got him at first. Barnes will not go. What a play by the catcher. And here comes Rosanna Gente Lahash with two outs. And Lahash was hit by a pitch. Two outs now, runners on second and third. Lahash hits this one back to first. It finds its way through. One run scores. Stacy on his horse. He will score, and the Warhawks have taken the lead. And remember, this Pee Wee team last year were kings of the comeback, coming back from five games down. When they were down three or more, they trailed by five earlier. And it's fouled back, 0-1 the count. And Jackson Norton, who singled and drove a run, or singled and got a run in by scoring back in the second, now steps in the bat. Kahnawake 7, DDO 5. Off the plate and 1-1. This has been a fantastic game. Warhawks 7, Dodgers 5. Here in the bottom of the third, there's two outs and a runner on first. Hit well, and it's going to find its way to the outfield. Shuisha picks it up. And that's a single for Jackson Norton. And here comes Rasandahoe Gabriel. Gabriel 1-for-1 with an inside the park grand slam earlier. And the outfielders are clearly giving him the respect following that last hit. 7-5 Warhawks, bottom of the third inning. And he skies this one to shallow right, but foul. Warhawks have scored two in this inning and have taken the lead. The pitch. It's in there. And Wiseman's one strike away from getting out of this jam, surrendering just two. But that's not going to be the case here as it misses the plate. 7-5 Warhawks, bottom of the third inning. Fouled back, and I'm very happy I didn't park near the field. What a catch! What a catch by one of the players, or one of the Bantam players. How about that? Dejo Daibo making the play. And he's fouled back by Lahash. We may be seeing him and the Bantam Warhawks this Saturday. That team's gotten off to a strong start after winning the regular season title last season. Yeah. That's upstairs and away, or at least inside, and it will blow the count here. 3-2. Warhawks 7, Dodgers 5. That looked like a good pitch too from Wiseman. Hit to shallow left. It drops! There you see it! It dropped! One run is in! Now the runner trying to go to third! They miss it! And now Lahash is going! Gabriel's going for another grand slam! He scores! Rasandahoe Gabriel 2-for-2 with two home runs and seven runs driven in, and the Warhawks have taken a 10-5 lead heading to the top of the fourth inning. Welcome back to the Sunnyside Diner Game of the Week on Baby Blue Memories. It's the top of the fourth inning. 10-5 lead for Kahnawake over DDO, but back to the top of the lineup for the Dodgers as Weishart hits this one. It hops by Rice. The throw to first is in time for out number one. As Russell Dahoway Gabriel makes the play. And Marco Piccioni will step in. Dodgers 1-0 on the season following a 14-1 win in their season opener. That was against the St. Laurent Black Crush. Hit to short, caught by Kate Stacey on a rope. The second baseman makes the play for out number two. This inning has lasted 50 minutes. If you're the Dodgers, take a couple of pitches here. 50 seconds so far and counting. Take a couple of pitches. Make Marcus Rice work, because remember, this is his third inning of work. And that's strike one. Cage McCumber warming up in the Warhawks bullpen. As is. Diablos number 24, and that pitch misses away, and it's 1-1. 3-1, sorry. So will Norton be stepping in the pitch? The wind is starting to pick up here at the hospital ball field. That misses the plate. So this is exactly what the Dodgers need here. Just take a little bit of time. Warhawks have had a couple of monster innings here. Take your time, get back to be focused on what you do best, which is draw walks, get on the base paths, and cause some havoc. And now it's 3-1. Marcus Rice trying to get out of this inning. 1-2-3. And that misses, and there we go. We got a base runner aboard for the Dodgers. And Elliot Lennon is coming up to bat, the cleanup hitter. The 10-5 lead for the Warhawks in the top of the fourth. Here it is. And he misses, and the runner's going. The throw to second, not in time. And Miles Spinner has moved up 90 feet. And now he's on second. Hit well to short, it gets through. Barnes throws it in. Not gonna be a time, runner's going. The throw, out at home. Big defensive play ends the top of the fourth. Warhawks coming back up to bat, up by five. Hi. 10-5 lead for the Warhawks as we welcome you back to the hospital ball field, bottom of the fourth inning. And there's a shot to center. Great catch! What a grab in center field. I believe Parker Shoren, who's made the move to center. That's the first out. It was a well-hit ball by Joran Norton. And now Marcus Rice will step in. Rice was hit by a pitch back in the second. Oh. Accidentally nicked the catcher who's trying to dust off the plate. So one down. And I'm assuming the open inning is coming up. As it's 8:23. Remember, this is a 7 o'clock start time. So one last chance for DDO coming up afterwards. and that misses the plate. Really important for the Warhawks to try to tuck on some more here. Foul back. I remember DDO scored 14 times last week in one game. They're capable, especially in an open inning. Today they scored 5 in the first. They maxed out and since then have not been able to get one across. Two very close calls though at home. And those bang bang plays as an umpire, that's really nuts. That's what you get paid for, really. And that is behind Rice and it's ball 4. And now Casey Diabuse will step in. She drew a walk back in the first and struck out in the second. 10-5 lead for the Warhawks here. That's in there for a called strike one, it's 0-1. Kahnawake has a runner on first. That's in there, called strike two. And Weishart with a couple of good pitches to start this at bat and it's fouled back to the Warhawks dugout. Hit well, right back to the pitcher, the throw to first in time. Rice will get to second. Right back to the pitcher, Weishart, who makes the decision to throw it to first for the sure out. And there's two down for Ethan Brascoop. That's in there, right at the knees, 0-1. Down Broadway at the knees, 0-1 the count. Misses the bag. Remember, you got... Right now, with the Warhawks up 5, they're not allowed to steal. There's a swing and a miss, and that is gonna do it. So Weishart gets the Dodgers into a prime position to try and make this comeback. It's 10-5 Warhawks heading into the top of the fifth inning. Leakopoulos, Shoren, and Rosen do up. You're watching Baby Blue Memories, Kahnawake by 5. All right, so I've just been notified that this is not the open inning, but in fact, we're going to play another one after this. So the DDO Dodgers with plenty of at-bats remaining. We'll see what they can get done against Cade Stacey. Marcus Rice, 3 innings pitched, no runs allowed. And Cade Stacey is in to face Maximus Leakopoulos, who lays off the high heat, 1-0 the count. Warhawks leading this one by a score of 10-5 over DDO. Hit well to second. Caught at second base for out number 1. As Jaden Norton makes the catch. And now Parker Shoren is coming in. He had that catch in center field. A splendid catch. And not a bad day for him either. He's walked and singled, scored a run as well. And he's gonna get hit by a pitch, I think, here. Nope. That hit the catcher's leg, my bad. 1-0 the count, Warhawks 10, Dodgers 5. On the ground, a comebacker, right this Cade Stacey, he knocks it down. The throw to first, he misses! And Parker Shoren's aboard for the third time today. You're the Warhawks, you just gotta shake that one off. Brandon Rosen steps in, the ball misses. Dodgers with the runner on first here, one down in the top of the fifth inning, the second to last inning. Hit on a rope, back to Gabriel at a second, or short I should say, for out number two. And as Wellows will step in, he has walked twice. Also has an RBI, that came back in the first. That's in there, strike one from Cade Stacey. And now the windup and pitch. Off the plate for ball one. That's strike two, and it's one and two. What a pitch by Cade Stacey trying to get out of this inning. Ooh, and he nearly bucked him. Runner's going. And he's going to get in there standing. A stolen base for Shoren. And Shoren gets it to scoring position. Every run is big. That's strike three on Azuelos, and we're heading into the bottom of the fifth. Warhawks on top by five. Welcome back to the hospital ball field, bottom of the fifth inning. This, of course, the Sunnyside Diner game of the week. Sunnyside Diner now open for dine-in. And we serve breakfast until 2 p.m. Calls today, 450-65-7983, Sunnyside Diner, where it's always sunny in this back to the action. Bottom of the fifth inning. Leakopoulos has come in to pitch. And he's facing the 3-4-5 hitters, so Barnes, Stacey, and McCumber. Barnes has walked twice and scored a run. And those are our two at-bats today. Swings and is behind this one, and it's a 1-1 count. And she's behind in the count now, 1-2. Warhawks 10, Dodgers 5. And there's strike three for the first out of this bottom of the fifth inning. And now Cade Stacey will step in. He grounded out and drew a walk and scored. Leakopoulos throwing heat to start this one up, but that's a little too high. And ball one. And that wind, I'll tell you what, has started to pick up. It's blowing to our right. Could be pretty dangerous if there's a pop fly hit. That one hops the bag, 2-0. Trust me, if that ball gets hit up in the air, there's no guarantee that it's going to land where it looks like it will. Wind has really picked up, and it's been breezy throughout, but especially in this inning as the skies have gotten grayer. And that strike one catches the upper corner, upper inside, and it's 2-1. That's strike two at the knees, and it's an even count, 2-2. That's right down Broadway, and that's a second strikeout for Leocopolis. Two outs, and for Cage McCumber, he will step into bat now. That's strike one. Leocopolis throwing smoke here for the Dodgers. That's off the plate, ball one, 1-1. Kahnawake on top, 10-5 over DDO. The windup and the pitch. Up high. Good eye by Cage McCumber. 3-0 the count on McCumber. And that's going to one-hop the bag. Three balls, one strike. Two down here. Bottom of the fifth inning. Warhawks 10, DDO Dodgers 5. On the ground to first. That's fair. Down the right field line. No, it's foul. But Cage McCumber hit that one well, put it in a good spot, just a bit foul. And we've got a full count now. Hit that one right to opposite field, right down the right field line, but just foul. That's outside. And McCumber will draw a walk. And in steps Jada Norton. She is 0-for-1, walked and scored in the second, grounded out back in the third. And now we have the DDO manager visiting his coach, so that gives us a nice little time to look and see that coming up in the next few weeks, in the next few days, this Pee-wee team, the U-13 Warhawks, they play three more games. They'll be playing Thursday, Friday, Sunday. Bantams and Midgets are also playing this weekend at the sports complex. Saturday, a doubleheader at the Plex. The Bantams will be playing at 10, the Midgets will be playing at 1. We may have both of those games for you as well. This is the plate. Jaden Norton ahead of this count, 2-0 on Leocopolis. That's going to catch the corner at the knees, 2-1. Warhawks leading the Dodgers 10-5 here. Norton behind that pitch, and now it's an even count, 2-2. One strike away from seeing an open inning at the top of the sixth. Kahnawake 10, DDO 5. That misses. Remember, over at first, Cage McCumber can't exactly run because there's no steals when you got a 5-run lead. And that's what the Warhawks are holding on to right now. Wind just picked up a violent sandstorm in the infield. That's ball four. And now it Carson Agete Lahash will step in. Kahnawake 10, DDO 5. The Warhawks have scored the last 10 runs of the ball game. Upstairs. Mosquito A Warhawks will be in action tomorrow visiting Valley Field. Back here Thursday. Warhawks on top, 10-5. Leading DDO. Fouled back and it's now 2-1. Wind once again has picked up a violent sandstorm in the infield. Runners, defenders, batters, catchers, watch out. And now it's a 2-2 count on the hash. We have a timeout as the DDO catcher is in need of some assistance behind home plate. There you see that wind picking up some steam. All right, Lahash will step back in. See some of the sand going right into the direction of the third base coach, Ronnie Stacy.
He's part of the game too, right?
That misses, it's a full count. Well, looking ahead to DDO, Suiza, Elbaz, and Weishart would be the three batters for the Dodgers. They're hoping that they got to come back for five runs instead of more, which they are one strike away from achieving. That's ball four, and the bases are now loaded. And Jackson Norton will step in. He is 2-for-2, has scored twice. Bases loaded, two outs, 10-5, Kahnawake leading. Upstairs, 1-0 on Jackson Norton. Don't forget, a walk would force in a run. That one hops a bag and the catcher looks like he's all right, but I'll tell you what, that's the second time that the ball has hit him. Seems to be fine. He was slow to get up earlier this inning. And there's a foul ball, which will make it 2-1. Oh, now I'm starting to eat some of this dust storm that's generated in the infield. Feel like the sunglasses are now not optional. That's in there, strike two. Leocopoulos one strike away from getting out of this jam. And Norton behind on that, it's strike three. The Acropolis gets out of the jam, and now the Warhawks hoping to close the door on the DDO Dodgers in the next inning. 10-5, Kahnawake, you're watching Baby Blue Memories. We welcome you back to the Arena Ball Field. Last chance for the DDO Dodgers. It's a 10-5 game. Top of the sixth inning and some very blustery conditions. So this could be the wild card, so to speak. As Swisha steps in against Cade Stacey. There's strike one. 1-1 the count. Cade going for a two-inning save. Warhawks on top by five. Hit well right to Cade Stacey. He throws the first, and that is out number one of this sixth inning. And Nathan Elbaz will step in 0-for-1 officially. He walked and grounded out thus far. He does have a run driven in back in the first inning, and that was the last run the Dodgers have been able to get across the Warhawks here. And Elbaz misses a strike one. Oh, it's 0-1. It's a 1-1 count. Oh, well, these windy conditions are making the windy weather is making conditions a little tough in that infield right now. 2-1 now the count. Warhawks on top of the DDO Dodgers by a score of 10-5. This is the last inning for DDO, the open inning. Dodgers, and James Weishart is in. He grounded out and has walked twice. He also scored, and behind on this pitch, it's 0-1. Warhawks, top of the sixth inning. Weishart fouls this one back. Good job protecting that plate. Now it's a two-strike count to him, though. He's got a runner on first. Ooh, that's going to be upstairs. Back on the base paths, however, Elbaz deciding not to go for it. He can steal because his team is not winning. Remember, the rule is if you're winning by five or more runs. And we've got a full count here, 3-2 on Elbaz. One out here, top of the sixth. That's high, and it's ball four. And the Dodgers hoping to rally back into this one. Marco Piccioni is in, 0-for-2 with a walk and a run scored. He's also lined out and grounded into a fielder's choice. Scoring position for the Dodgers. Fouled back. DDO making this one interesting, that's for sure. Warhawks up five, but two runners in scoring position for DDO with one out. And that's upstairs, and now the bases are loaded. There's a force though at any bag. So now the lead runners, Elbaz and Weishart. Elbaz has to run because there's a force now at home. That's strike one, 0-1. Good pitch from Cade Stacy. Went up against Miles Spinner. He is 1-for-1, but has reached base three times. Two walks and a single. 10-5, Warhawks leading. And a walk here would force a run in. Swung on a miss, strike two. 2-2, Cade Stacy with a strike here. This would be a huge strikeout, definitely, after three straight walks. And he fouls it right back. Spinner making Stacy work here. As the sun sets and the lights come on. It's a full count, 3-2. Popped. And that's gonna fall into right field. That's a base hit. One run scores, two run scores. There's a throw to home. Not gonna be in time. It is a two run double. And it's now 10-7. Pichoni on third. Spinner with a huge hit, and now Lennon steps in. He is 2-for-3, two singles and is lined out. And now Lennon represents the game tying run. One out. Lennon and then Leocopoulos do up. And Lennon behind on that one, 0-1. Some high heat from Cade Stacy. One and one. One ball, one strike. Warhawks 10, Dodgers 7. Popped, foul, and now it's 1-2. And that's low. Two balls, two strikes. That's in there, strike three, two down. And Leocopoulos will step in, representing the tying run. One more out needed for the Warhawks. Off, 10-7, Kahnawake leading. DDO has two runners on. They've scored twice in this open inning, but they need another three to keep it going. Upstairs, 1-0 the count, two down. That's 2-0. Parker Soren is on deck, and don't forget, he is 3-for-3 tonight. And now it's 3-0. That's ball four, and a four-pitch walk loads the bases. And now the tying run is aboard, and the potential leading run is stepping into bat right now. And it's the hot hand, Parker Soren, who is 3-for-3 with three singles tonight. And 7, Kahnawake leading. Ball, 2-0. One more out needed. Popped! Caught! And the Warhawks win! What a ball game tonight at the hospital ball field. But victory will go to the Kahnawake Warhawks, winning their season opener here. A thriller at the hospital ball field. 10-7, they beat the DDO Dodgers. That was one heck of a ball game. Well, that was one heck of a ball game. The Warhawks win it 10-7. DDO falls to 1-1. The Warhawks 1-0, but plenty of action coming up for them over the next few ball games. We should be seeing you Thursday night in Valley Field when the Midget Warhawks play Valley Field. Your final score here at the hospital ball field, Kahnawake 10, DDO 7. I'm Brandon Bortle for Baby Boo Memories, and we are out of here on a giveaway.